I'm Stuti Shukla. You are watching Agribusiness News. Let's start with latest updates. CSE e-governance service India has collaborated with Krishak Bharati Cooperative to provide access to fertilizers and agricultural inputs to farmers via 4 lakh village level entrepreneurs. Common service centers will facilitate the sale and distribution of crypto products which include fertilizers. Elaborating on the partnership, CSE e-governance services India Limited Managing Director Dinesh Tyagi said our alliance with crypto is a step ahead in furthering the agenda of the government in serving the farmers and agriculture community. In the presence of Union Minister of Chemicals and Fertilizers and Health and Family Welfare Mansukh Mandaviya, a practical field trial of drone spraying of nano liquid urea was conducted in Bhavnagar, Gujarat. The trial was attended by a large number of farmers. This demonstration of spraying liquid nano urea by drone was undertaken by IFFCO. A company involved in developing nano urea, Mansukh Mandaviya said, not only has nano urea been produced on a large scale today, but we are happy that farmers are adopting it on a large scale since the very beginning. Adani Green Energy Limited has completed the acquisition of SB Energy India for $3.5 billion. It is the largest solar power developer in the world, which made SB Energy Holdings Limited a subsidiary with this deal. SB Energy India is now 100% subsidiary of AGEL. Earlier, it was an 80-20 joint venture between Japan-based SoftBank Group Corporation and Bharti Group. World Bank Finance Assam Agribusiness and Rural Transformation Project is promoting premium quality rice, particularly the Johar through market-led demonstration. A part stated that the project provides these fertilizers and need-based pesticide to the beneficiaries farmers in the integrated crop management demonstration, whereas in mini kits only seed is provided to the farmers. Assam Chief Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma launches Mission Basundhara at a program organized by the Revenue and Disaster Management Department in Guwahati. The mission is a decisive step towards streamlining land revenue service and facilitating easy access to the public for their land-related work. CM Himanta Biswa said securing land rights of indigenous population is the prime objective of the mission. The public, especially the poor and disadvantaged section, must be able to get their land-related work done through Mission Basundhara. Tamil Nadu government has approved extension of the scheme of transactional production incentive to sugarcane farmers for 2020 to 2021 crushing season. Tamil Nadu government has approved extension of the scheme of transactional production incentive to sugarcane farmers for 2020 to 2021 crushing season and also sanctioned a sum of 39.40 crore rupees. A government order says that the TPI for 2020 to 2021 crushing season will be paid at 42.50 rupees per ton to farmers who have supplied sugarcane to sugar mills. 110th All India Farmer Fair and Agro-Industrial Exhibition will be organized by GB Pant University of Agriculture and Technology, Pantnagar from 7 to 10th October 2021 at Pantnagar, Uttarakhand. It will attract large number of agrochemical industries, firms and farmers. Major activities are scale of quality seeds and planting materials, animal shows, fishery production, exhibition, horticulture shows, scientific exhibition and field visits. For more updates, keep watching Krishi Jagran. Thank you.